morning, brothers and sisters in Christ.
Good morning.
Let me first bring greetings from the Evangelical Lutheran Church in Zimbabwe and also Dube Parish, which is your dream parish. Today, I'm going to preach from the first letter, the book of Genesis, chapter 3, which was the first letter which was read. I have put the theme of this Sunday, temptations come and go. Temptations come. Ed and I were talking when we were traveling around New York City and this Synod. And every time he gave me time to speak, he used to say, "Pardon me. Pardon me." But let me say, this is my last Sunday here at Upstate, New York. I'm rounding up and I'm tempted to preach more than 20 minutes today. Temptations come and they go. Yesterday when we were from the Messiah Lutheran Church with the Noblis family, they were telling me about sheep. A farm that is sheep. And I said, I want to see this farm. I want to see the sheep. And I was joking and saying, as a temptation, can we take one small sheep and put it into the suitcase? But that suitcase is not mine. The general secretary will own that suitcase until we reach his house. Why? Because if he found guilty, he has to be found guilty, not me. Those are temptations. We try to push temptations to other people. The book of Genesis is about many beginnings. The beginning of the universe. How the universe came about. The beginning of man, Adam. The beginning of a woman, Eve. The beginning of a human being. How man got into sin. The beginning of God's promise. And the beginning of God's plan of salvation. And the text today falls within this pre-biblical history, which we are looking at the beginning of Genesis, which talks about God and the human race, and the God about the various people. And this book of Genesis, at its beginning, it is telling the fact that the one true God is sovereign. Those who are presidents of countries talk of sovereign state. We are a sovereign state. And we are saying as Christians, one God is sovereign, is the God, the creator of human, the creator of heaven, the creator of this earth in which we live. Genesis introduces to us the way in which God initiates and enters into covenant. God entered into covenant with the human race. Many, right from Abraham, we can read about the covenant, how God made them. Temptation come and go. Temptations come and go. When God created the first man, Adam, it was after he had created everything. The trees were there. The mountains were there. The valleys were there. The wild animals were there. Tame the animals were there. And now in the end he said, let us create man in our image, in our life. And that was Adam. Mankind. And from the creation of Adam, God saw one thing. Adam was lonely. He could go to the cattle. There was no relationship, no talk. He could go to the pen. He could visit the trees, valleys. There was no companionship. There was no partnership. He was better off. And God sees and says, I make a mistake. I will make you a helper suitable for you. And God causes Adam to sin. And he takes out one of his limbs and he makes a woman. And when Adam gets up from the operation, he sees someone sitting there and he says, this is the bone of my bone. And Adam is enjoying. He embraces this bone of his bone. He embraces Eve as his companion, as a woman, a friend, a helper, in all the thinking, in all the praying, in all the doing, as a companion. Then he places them in the garden of heaven. Be there. All this belongs to you. Take over responsibility of all these animals. Tame them. Do whatever is good for them. Look after them. And conserve this tree. There, one day, Adam is not in the home. Eve is alone. We don't know what time of the day it was. But look. Satan comes to Eve. And he says, did God say you should eat all the things that are in this garden? And Eve says, the Lord has said we can eat all the fruits that are in this garden, but not the fruit in the middle of the garden. Then Satan says, okay, let's go and see. This is the fruit, says Eve. And Satan says, this fruit is good. Eat it. But Eve says, we have been started that if we eat of this fruit, we'll die. The Satan says, you enjoy it. You will not die. God is afraid that if you eat of this fruit, you will be clever, wiser, like him. Everyone wants to join. Everyone wants to be clever. Who cannot be tempted by that word or thought? In time, you will not die. People who are afraid of death, and the Lord has said, if you eat it, you will die. And they were afraid. But this demonic power of Satan comes and says, you will not die. Eat and see how you will be. They ate. And the plant it was very nice. She was waiting now for the husband to come back home and they give him an apple pie. My husband, my darling, my sweetheart. This tree that has been forbidden is very nice. Tested. And that was the first stage of for women and men, love. And they were naked. They were naked. Evening was dawning. Evening was coming. And they were hearing the footsteps of God coming. It was as if God had fellowship, God had conversion, God had relationship with Adam and Eve in the Garden of Eden. Every time in the evening at dawn, God is said to have come to them, they were to talk, they were to share, they were to laugh together, and they were to die together and feel good. But now they were naked. Does anyone want to be naked here? If you would walk naked, you say this, sir, there is something wrong upstairs. It was a shame for them to be found naked by God. We don't want to be naked. You can see if you use a common bathroom, in Africa at times they have a common bathroom where several people go under a big shower. You will try to be, you'll try to be shy. You don't want to be just yourself and free to wash. That's why you have made private bathroom so that people can bath freely. Because you are ashamed of your nakedness. And that time to Israel, to appear naked before God was an abomination for ancient Israel. In the camp, every form of body exposure was carefully guarded against. And Adam and Eve get to be ashamed. Temptations come and go. Adam and Eve have been tempted. Job was tempted. Satan asked Job from God and killed his kid. Plundered his property. And he became sick. And he could not sleep. Because he was stretching himself all over the body during the night and day, and had no rest. King David was tempted when he saw the wife of Uriah and said to his man, I like that woman, I love that woman, well take her from me. Jesus was tempted. Peter was tempted when he said to Jesus, you can't go, you can't do that. And he said, get behind me, Satan. At that time, Peter was threatening him because he was misdirecting him to follow and they fulfill the will of God in man. Temptation will come and go. What are our temptations? I say today, I am tempted to preach more than 20 minutes. Temptations come to us as people created in the image of God. There are people who are not tempted to divorce. There are people who are tempted to separate as husband and wife. There are people who are tempted to look down on the other people. When you voted to accept the gays and lesbians in your church here in ELCA, it was a temptation to other people. Some were left. Some have stayed home to say, I can't go along with this disease. That's a temptation. Because it has thrown someone out of church, and someone has done whatever he thinks is better. Some people are tempted to be individualistic. You don't want to mix. Even if you come to church, you go on like yourself or your family, and you don't want to mix. Church is a fellowship. Church is a company. Church is partnership. We have to move together and to be together in faith. No one thing in all these temptations. That God is with us, walking with us, either in good or evil, the Lord is not far away. He will find us. Some are tempted that if I preach more than 20 minutes, they will walk out of this church. Maybe to go and do some other things that are not connected to God. The good temptation is that we are all at church. We want to hear the word. We want to celebrate the whole community together. We want to sing together and be joyful. That is a good temptation. In your own strength, brother and sister, in all your power, in your own imagination, in all your own whatever you have, you will never conquer temptation. Temptations will come to you, whether you go to church or not. Temptations will never leave you. Temptations come and they go. Amen. Let us pray. Dear God, our Father, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, we thank you that you conquered all temptation through your word. And you teach us that if we are a new creation and stay in you, we will be tempted, but we will conquer. Not with our own strength, but through the strength that we get from you, through the power of your Holy Spirit. Abide in us all and see us through all temptations. In Jesus' name.